Cool.
Should I put one everywhere or just one?
How many can you make?
I'm just gonna give them one.
Does it use more star fragments to make them?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I would use more to
I
make
have
them.
a lot.
Do you see my other glove? Never mind, I'm sitting on it. Yeah. I think it's streaming right now. I'm about to call my dad and ask him to check it. Make sure it's working on his end. Huh? I think it's here. Hey. Go. I'm trying to stream this on YouTube and I want to see if it's working. So I want you to go and see if it's up. You should be able to see what I'm seeing. So when you get to YouTube, let me know and I'll tell you what to search for. All right, just type in Matthew Casey's live stream. I think that's what it's up as. All right, you can see me looking around. All right. Can you hear anything through it? Oh, one sec. Right, so it is streaming. All right. You should be able to hear me talking on it too, I think. All right. Can you hear me talking? Talking, 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 talking. Let's see. Hello? Hey. Can you hear the car? Here. Here, I'm revving the engine right now. Can you not see my screen right now? Oh, you can see it, yeah. So your stream's gonna be a little delayed from what I'm actually doing, so. Well, I can hear you, I can hear myself on there now, so I know you can hear it. All right, bye. I think you're on the wrong video. Trista? Trista. Did you find the right one? I think the one you were looking at was whenever I did the first test. Is the quality really bad? Alright, see what, down at the bottom, see what quality you can pull up. In the little settings menu. Do you see that? Yeah, whatever the highest available is. What is it? Is it 1080? Yeah, pick that and see what it looks like. Let me see what I'm outputting on my stream. Well, see if it gets any better. If not, oh well. I don't know. I have to do more research on how to stream correctly.
My check.
Yep.
Thank you. Hey, can I get a mic check?
I'm here.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Did the picture quality improve at all? Is it just grainy? I don't really know how to fix it. I know I've got like bit rate that I can control, but I don't really know. Oh, well, that's good. I'm gonna leave it alone then.
Sorry, Robert. I was just going for a lap.
Otter, radio check.
There's traffic behind. Watch your mirrors. Yellow flag. Caution. That's a new fastest lap for Miller on 16.4. Yellow flag. Off the pace in sector one. It's 20 minutes to go. That's your best lap in the session. Sector three times okay. That looked bad. Can you confirm that you're all right, please, Matthew? Thank you. disengage limiter. Tracks clear. Push, push, push.
It might have something to do with when you're in a session that can't be joined. Newbies that are good.
Okay, Matthew, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes.
On your right. Still there. Play right.
Out of the wall.
Sector one time's okay.
See if I can join the session properly so I can actually pull to everybody.
Okay, guys, starting a driver's meeting here. I got about 12 minutes left to practice. Couple new rules I wanted to go over before we did anything. Hopefully you guys read that, but I'm going to go over it for the new people that we have in here. First thing, we had a little bit of issues last week with some incidental contact. You know, that's going to happen. That was a really tight racetrack, which this one's even worse, looks like. We're gonna look at each situation, but going forward, the first penalty for any kind of incidental contact will be a drive-through penalty. The second will be a one-lap hold. The third will be a disqualification from the race. Any contact that the race control, me, David, or Chris determine to be intentional will be an instant disqualification. Some other things to talk about are yellow flags. We actually haven't thrown any yellow flags unless I'm misremembering, so that's pretty good that we haven't even had to do that. Looking like we'll judge each situation as it comes. If it's a three car wreck or more, or if
the
race
even if I'm joining
surface
that,
is
so I'm just gonna
blocked,
do it as watch.
We'll look at throwing a yellow flag, especially on a track like this. You are allowed to pit under yellow. We'll look at Lucky Dog. Doesn't look like this
meeting.
Time. We'll be for sure doing that unless that's an admin call that we deem is something we should do. It's going to be single file restarts. If it comes to a yellow flag,
I might
if it's
not
the
be able
three
to
guys
now.
On the back and they all wreck, they all get rolling pretty good, we're probably not going to throw yellow. It's going to be, like I said, it's going to be our discretion. And then if we have to throw a green right checkered, there's going to be an unlimited amount. Last couple things. We had an issue last week with a couple drivers that were blinking pretty heavily. We're going to give them two laps to see if their connection improves.
Session as a spectator because
if it does not, then we will ask them to pit until their connection can improve to where they're not blinking and causing you guys time and possibly a crash.
Hopefully it'll let me
we don't want
that.
To police you guys. We want to ask you that if you watch your relatives, if you
know.
See that you're a little bit slower than the leaders and they're coming up on you, please get out of the way. Don't make yourself a factor in the battle for the win or the lead or, whether it's lap 1 or lap 20 or lap 34. Just keep in mind of your surroundings. Last couple things. No lane change on the start.
That BMW
set was
actually
on restarts, we want the leader to go on green.
Just compared to...
You laying back, trying to get a big run, that'll be up to our discretion if we do anything there. It'll most likely be a drive-through, if anything.
Right.
But don't make us have to make a call there.
They actually focus a little bit because there's a lot more...
And if you do want an EOL on restarts or the start, let us know. We'll get you at the back because we know some people like to, have a little bit of safety net there towards the beginning of the race, especially when it gets pretty crazy. So with that, we got about 8-9 minutes left here. Let's have a good race.
Looks like you're clear on the pit exit.
You can't pimp it and go early. That's fair on this track, I would say. I would want to strongly discourage any fuckery for this track.
Right side, clear right. Left side. clear left.
Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. Sector 1 is 6.1, off the pace.
I guess the annoying thing is because I'm as a driver, I can't pull up the F3 box. I know, I just like to have it at hand.
Sector 2 is not
drive
through. Off the pace.
Just be very patient going into corners. No, I'm not disagreeing with you, I just... That's their rules. That's key to running a good league.
Yellow flag, watch out. The leader's just done it, 17.8.
Thank you, Chris.
Goodbye, Matthew. 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes left.
Bye-bye, Matt Houston. Yeah.
There's a car leaving the pits. Sector 3 is 0.4 off the pace.
Oh, God.
Just done a 115.9. It exits clear.
Thank you, Landon.
New fastest lap for Evans, 115.4.
Guy who has that incident thing just did the stupidest fucking move. Drag to rejoin. So be careful around David Stengel.
That's 2 minutes.
He's an admin, so it might have been a test case.
Yellow flag, caution.
That was like the dumbest shit I've seen. like grid penalties? I mean, that'd be a...
need to find a tent in sector 2.
I mean, that'd be a good punishment. Causing incident is a loss of a grid position. Causing severe incident, I should say. I knew I recognized that name, that John Maccioni. That was the guy that was messaging, that was talking about it in the pre-race.
Sector 1 is 0.4 off the pace.
You got 10 seconds left, so likely not.
Check a flag, V2.
Just remember to be safe and smart with traffic.
That's the end of the session, P2.
Nice.
Check a flag's out, P2.
He told the admin told me he wanted me to join the session grid and escape so that I don't like hold the gridding up. So I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I was just asking him, is there a way I can not inconvenience anybody? So
pit exit's clear, push. We've got 2 laps to get the job done.
Easy enough. Could y'all adjust it in the box? Could y'all adjust it previously?
You okay?
Did you get booted?
Your exit is clear. Watch the white line.
I can't see your qualifying session. But you got 10 minutes. You got 10 minutes if you reset yourself here. We'll still get one decent lap in it. You need a lap down though, because I guarantee you a lot of people are not going to have a lap down. So even if it's slow, something to get you ahead of the chaos, because if you're in the back of the field, you're just going to be fighting traffic the entire time. Okay. Take it easy, take it easy.
All clear on pit exit.
Okay. I was planning on just sitting at my desk normal. Not in this awkward cockeyed way to have my car, I mean my rig set up. Yeah, because I had to configure controls. I had to be on, and so I had to bring it close to the power supply. That's not bad at all. I mean, that's all right though. I've seen Thomas wreck a lot. Well, good news is my relative does work now. So I can kind of help you. I can't help you on fuel. It will. At this point, everyone's qualified. Be careful. Think I can get a blind fire qualifying lap down? thought you were back. I was about to ask, do you think I can get a blind fire qualifying lap down? Never run this in the IndyCar? Yeah. I mean, I'm good. I am John. Okay. You know stuff. Words. Okay, I'll be the star of the show. Well, I think, I mean, that's how most of the streamers have it. Like, whoever's in their Discord shows up on their stream. So you just get to be the star of the show. You are going to be the outside going into turn one. Just remember that. Just be smart with it.
That's the end of the session.
Even if you have to drop to fifth. Oh, come on. Yeah, I grid, but I was hoping it won't let me keep the F3 box up. That's a shame. No, I'm telling you, like, when I go back out, like, unless I go to the pits. Try that. All I can pull up is the radio. I might join in the pits. That might be the way to go. Literally all I have on the black box right now is the radio channels. I'd be able to see the relative, and it's a small track, so I should be able to track you pretty well on it. Or at the very least, give you an idea of what's going on in the pit entry area. Yeah, that ain't gonna happen.
Good luck, everybody.
Good luck.
Take it smooth.
The air temp is 65 Fahrenheit, 40 laps. Follow car number 4 in the left lane.
Yeah, there are going to be some
bumps.
That's
my bad, sorry.
Okay, Matthew, be ready.
You're good.
Watch
the lights. You're good. Okay, guys. Good luck here. Let's have a good race.
Green, green, green.
Thanks, Adam.
Blue flag.
Good start. Yep, they're wrecking behind you.
That was my bad there.
the guy in front, the gap is 0.4. Increase to 1.0 seconds.
Jim, if you catch me here, just let me know.
Is that contact there or not? Your pass.
Well done, Matthew. Nice move, mate.
Yeah, no, you... Yeah, that was your spot right there.
Thanks, bud.
Sorry, man. Sorry, man. I did not expect to be that slow coming out.
Confirm, Lennon.
All good. No damage, and honestly, nobody could get around you right there. You're showing no damage to me. On my screen, you're good. Just less pressure for you to try to get on that guy. You've got 5 seconds to Maccioni.
The car behind's pitting.
Inside. You gotta say that a lot earlier, my dude.
That guy was spinning. Be smooth around him. That's Matt Houston again.
On lap 4, it'll close on lap 22. 6.6 seconds.
That front wing damage finally showed up for me.
It's a car leaving the pits. Awesome stuff, mate. Keep it coming. That's the fastest lap.
Good clean.
There's an incident here. Turn 13.
Lap traffic, you just spun.
Yellow flag. Incident in turn 4.
No one in between you and second right now. Yeah, just run it smooth. You're guaranteed third if you're unclean.
Front is now 6.9 seconds.
What's that drive-through 4 for 4?
Thomas got a drive-through. Yeah, that didn't seem correct. He was issuing one for, oh god, passing this nice guy, be ready for shit.
There was contact between, the 4 and the 61. On lap 4.
No, he had contact on lap 4.
It was late, a late inside. The 61 was a little bit wide, but it did damage both cars.
So this is legit. Thomas Good has a drive-through penalty. Lap 4, yeah, hold on. Yeah.
Can I ask for some confirmation to make sure it was the 4 car?
Yes, that is confirmed. Number 4.
Yeah, it is. It is legit. I watched it. He didn't really hit him. I don't. That's a shitty penalty. But yeah, but I did not. I was not able to see what happened to you.
Nice one, Matthew. You're looking really good. Come on, keep your focus. Me too. You've just done it. 119.3. Has binned it in. Turn 13. Incident 10. Turn 1. lap was at 17.1.
You've had a lot of contact here at the beginning, guys. Let's get it back to where it needs to be.
Lap traffic ahead of you.
There's an incident in turn 11.
Car left. Clear left.
Good pass. That was kind of...
Colby, please be aware you have the leader coming up behind you.
I just can't hear you. You're breaking up. Say again, please.
Can you still hear me now, Matt?
It's catching. The gap's now.
What were you saying about my mic? Sorry, I don't know what it was.
Incident in turn 11, yellow flag, caution. Incident in turn 4, looks like it's Miller.
You should be catching up to Ayrton Smith right now, and he fucked up. Don't worry about that.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
P6 has gone off in turn 1. That was 116.8. I think P6 has pinned it in turn 2.
Are you still looking good to make it a one stop?
I'll let you go.
P2.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're one stop, you're good. Would be lap 20 then. I mean lap 21, just to be safe. Or honestly 20 though, you'll be safe. Yeah, if you just pit lap 20, you'll have enough fuel to the end. If you just top it off.
Yeah,
you could. I would pit 19. I wouldn't pit 18 just to be extra safe. You never want. 19 will get it.
Sorry, Connor. All good, my dude.
Yeah, I was just trying to get out of the way. I knew that was going to be the line you were going to see, so...
Incident in turn 1. incident in turn two. That lap was at 116.5. You're 2/10 off the pace in sector one. You're 1/10 off the pace in sector two. Sector three is 2/10 off the pace. The gap behind is now 7.0.
Are you on? What lap are you on? Look at your relative. I can't see it. You might want to pit soon because Cohen lost a good chunk of time due to traffic right there. So I'm assuming you're about to enter some traffic.
Go, go, go.
Right.
All right, Matthew. You got about 4 laps of fuel left.
Staying to the right.
Pit this lap.
For the pit speed limit. When we exit the pits, we should be in position
next,
3, just okay. Behind 6th place. Understood. You got about 3 laps of fuel left. Behind, take care, rejoin him.
You're good on all these guys.
There's an incident in turn 4. It looks like Smith. Yellow flag, watch out.
Left side. Clear left.
Good pass. Thomas is pitting now. That's all right. He is in his box now. Pulling out.
Okay, Matthew, that's half distance. Fuel level.
You're still ahead, you're good. You have a clean car now. You're faster than him with a clean car.
Turn 1. I think P3's gone off.
Oh, he spun out of the pits too. Good work. It's a Take it easy, and you've got the bridesmaid spot again. I mean, hell, if Cohen just has a DNF, that gets you a championship. So all you gotta do is have a friend who just conveniently wrecks out Cohen one week. If only there was a friend in the league, technically.
You're pulling away from the guy behind. The gap's now 15 seconds.
Cohen, no. He's probably going to run it to empty, so he'll have a faster car at the end. I mean, he has that liberty, too. He's fast. Yeah, good start. If you didn't have that wall bang at the beginning, you might have been able to compete a little bit. I mean, hell, second's not a bad position. Yeah, you just got to run this the rest of the way.
Evans is pitting. Evans.
You heard that. Leaders in the pits. Means you didn't practice enough mistakes.
Looks like it's Evans. That lap time was
16.9. Cohen's difference just went up massively. I'm watching him leave the pits on this. No, he didn't spin out of pits.
Reeling Evans in. The gap is 12 seconds.
Well, I get. Oh, okay, this lap will actually tell us. I forgot that he technically crosses the line. He's good, you just gotta hope he sucks at ovals, maybe.
Sector 1 is quick, you're a tenth off the pace in sector 2, you're 2/10 off the pace in sector 3.
Yeah, you're actually catching up. You might be able to press him into a mistake if you just slowly pick away at his.
Thanks, Jim.
So you're getting a little dangerous there, clattering those curbs. Imagine you're about to run into a horde of traffic. Just gotta deal with it. Take it easy. Took another second off Cohen. He feels you. Good work by Colby. I'm not complaining. This guy has not been very good with letting people by. He has a penalty already. Take it easy.
There's an incident in turn one. B2. The lap time was 17.2. There's an incident in turn two. Incident in turn seven.
Damn. It's all good. It's a lap to everybody else. Oh, shit. Get in there and get back out. You can still get good points.
The gap behind has now decreased to...
Right side. Still there. Clear right. On your right. Clear right.
Hello.
Turn B3's gone off in turn three.
Good spin. Shit happens. It's a hard track.
What's your speed limit in the pits? Okay, Matthew. Should be
uncheck everything.
On exit, we should be in position three.
You do? Oh, cool.
Limiter's still on. Disengage it. Its exit looks clear.
Not bad. Take it easier.
Looks like P5's gone off in turn two. seconds.
You were actually faster than Cohen there. You were consistently gaining at least a quarter second.
Time was at 116.5. Your sector 2 and 3 times are good. Sector 1 is number 3 off the pace.
Guy in front of you spun.
Six has gone off in turn 3.
Yeah, I saw that. I still am happy with mine. Yeah.
There's an incident in turn 5. You think it might be Smith?
See, I just have a Chromecast, so...
That lap was at 16.5.
Picture quality is still good, so I have no issue. Feeling kind of bad for Jared. I saw something he posted the other day that he's apparently moving like 2 days before Le Mans. He says that's his plan.
front is now 10 seconds. That's the fastest lap of the race.
You have the fastest lap of the race. That last one was. Yeah, fastest lap of the race. According to the YouTube commentator. Is nice.
That was a 17.6.
In fact, I'll say it, shitty. No, I'm not saying that. I just. No, just one. Yeah. Well, that's disappointing. This guy is pretty shitty. Yeah. This guy's clueless. What is it? Oh, that's fucking awful. Why not just go with the sure thing, like Formula Ones? I don't know how they're. I'm assuming theirs is pretty similar to F1. No, you've had a huge amount of dropout. P7 is the last running car. Yep. I could roll out right now if you want.
That last lap was a 17.6.
Thanks, Jim.
He heard you. Yeah, probably.
The gap in front is now 11 seconds. You've just done a 16.6. Sector 2 and 3 are fast. You're 2/10 off the pace in Sector 1.
Two to go, finish it. The commentator is comparing lap times of Thomas in first place when the race is clearly over. Like he's doing a sector breakdown. He could have done that earlier when he had nothing. Oh. Well, yeah, it doesn't matter. You got two laps to Ayrton. You can park it if you want, but I'd rather finish on lead lap. Yeah, this is true. Yes. Well, I'll get, good job. Gotta deal with what you gotta deal with. I'm hopping off. I'll see you later. Good race. Of course.
Checkered flag, guys. Cohen, number 17, is your winner. Great drive, man. Appreciate you guys sticking around. like Chris said, if you want to go to Discord, if you want to be interviewed on the broadcast, top three to the waiting room channel.
Good race. Nice job, everybody.
Incident in turn three. It looks like it's Smith. Looks like P4 has gone off in turn three. Well done, Matthew. Great drive. That's a podium.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Good job coming home third, even though you hit the wall a couple of times.
Matthew, Robert up here in the booth. You got a copy, buddy. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you there. Oh, it's going, man. Well, you tell me. How do you like this track? It's very bumpy and crazy, ain't it? Yeah, yeah, it's tough. It's tough. What was the main thing that you struggled with out here? All right, sorry about that. Apparently, my mic muted there. No one was hearing what you were saying, so now we're fixed. Go ahead. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I seen a lot of guys tonight, you know, getting into the turns, hitting the brakes, and it seemed like you locked them up really, really fast. What was the cause of that? Because I seen a lot of guys doing it. Mm-hmm. Right, right. All right, man. Well, hey, you're bringing home third place. Helps you in the points. Up one position. You started fourth here tonight. Next week, we head to Indy. I'm sure you're going to be happy to run that track. Yeah, when I seen this track on the schedule, buddy, I was like, oh, my God. I knew right away, man, it is tough. But all right, man. Well, congratulations on your third place finisher. Does anybody want to give a shout out before you pack up and say, see you later, Detroit? All right. All right. Good job. Good job. All right. Well, man, I'll catch you next week at Indy. You too.
Yep, thanks, buddy. We appreciate it.